Glycine, your ticket to a better night's sleep. If you're a longtime viewer of our channel, then this video might come as a surprise. It will have a different format than what you're used to. There will be no top and no importance order, just facts laid out, but we need to tell you this too. If you watch this video all the way to the end, then we'll tell you which foods are the best to eat to get glycine into your system. Glycine. That's not a word that you hear too often. It doesn't have as much acclaim on it as calcium, zinc, or even iron, but it should. Glycine is one of the most important amino acids in your body. From the heart to the brain, your gut, and joints, everything uses glycine to function. There's no part of your body that isn't affected positively by having enough glycine in your system. This protein building block has numerous benefits for your health. It's pretty easy to get deficient in it, but we're jumping ahead of ourselves. Let's take a closer look at what glycine actually is. Glycine's name comes from the Greek word glycos, which is a word that means sweet tasting. This is because it has a naturally sweet flavor to it. It's something that's been around for a long time because it's been such a long-standing bit of knowledge. You know that it's information that you can trust. In 1829, French chemist Henri Braconnot isolated and identified glycine by mixing sulfuric acid with gelatin. There was little obvious use for it. As is often the case with scientific discoveries, the world didn't find use for it until years later. The sweet flavor would become useful. Today, it's used as a sweetener and is a popular dietary supplement. You can find it in everything from sucralose to saccharin. If those words sound familiar to you, it's because they're two of the most commonly used sugar substitutes in the United States. The yellow packet is sucralose, the pink packets are saccharin, and they both have glycine in it. What makes glycine so special is that your body can manufacture it on its own. That means it's something that the human form produces to try and keep itself running properly, the same way that our body naturally produces serotonin. But for some of you, that may not always be the case. See, the human body is a fragile thing, just like some brains cannot produce enough serotonin. Some bodies are not able to produce enough glycine. In fact, a lot of us are highly glycine deficient. So, you might not have enough glycine in your system. If that's the case, then you're going to start having some serious negative health effects. Glycine has multiple benefits to human health. It can also have a negative impact on the health of people who are deficient in it. Just like an iron deficiency can cause fainting spells, glycine deficiencies can cause their own problems. Having enough glycine in your system can help with skin elasticity and collagen production. It can also increase insulin sensitivity, helping with weight loss. Having enough glycine in our system can start to help undo liver damage caused by alcohol. And glycine can also reduce sun damage, glutathione. Protecting your heart, your muscles, and your gut becomes much easier when you have enough glycine in your system. But that's not it. There are two other super helpful things that glycine can do. See, glycine can both enhance cognition and it can improve sleep. Two things that can in turn lead to a better quality of life for you. Now you might be wondering, how does glycine work and why is it so important for me? Let's dive deeper. Glycine works in different parts of your body, particularly in your brain. Let's start there first because the glycine levels in your brain are hyper important and can make a massive difference in your lifestyle. This is because it modulates inhibitory neurotransmitters like GABA and serotonin, which are brain chemicals that help you relax and fall asleep. Serotonin also affects your mood. If you don't have enough serotonin in your body, then you're going to find yourself struggling with anxiety and with clinical depression. Glycine can also potentiate NMDA excitatory receptors as well. This affects things like memory, cognition, immune function. If you find yourself struggling to think or constantly forgetting about what's happening or what needs to be done next, it might be time to look into getting more glycine into your system. Having enough glycine in your system can also help improve your immune system and prevent you from getting sick as easily or as frequently. Glycine is most known for its effects on sleep. If you're struggling to get to sleep at night or stay asleep at night, then you're going to need to get more glycine in your body now. This is because it promotes deep recuperative rest by increasing blood flow to your extremities. This lowers your core body temperature, which makes it easier to knock out. Simply said, glycine equals lower body temp equals deeper sleep. Some research shows that it can also increase serotonin levels in your brain, something that we mentioned very briefly a few moments ago. Let's take a closer look at this one though, shall we? Serotonin is one of the easiest things for a brain to get deficient in. This is because it's super easy for your body to simply stop creating serotonin, which is used to make melatonin, sleep hormone. Glycine was also studied for its effects on mental health. Research shows it may help with bipolar OCD schizophrenia. Glycine's role in schizophrenia is fascinating. Schizophrenics have less NMDA receptors in their brain and less glycine in their blood. As such, it's easy to see the connection between the symptom and the cause. Glycine plays a vital part in you being your healthiest. Because of that, we made sure to figure out how to get more glycine in your body. Supplements for glycine are hard to come across, and they honestly can be super hard on the wallet. It's a lot easier for you to simply change your diet and get more glycine into your system that way. Here are some of the best foods you should incorporate in your life to get more of it. Bone broth, meat on the bone, seafood, poultry skin, legumes. Make sure to soak first. As you can see, there are plenty of things that you can eat to get more glycine into your system. You can even make your own bone broth by using a crock pot, water, chicken bones, and a splash of apple cider vinegar. And if you want to check out the legumes, everything from black beans to kidney beans carry glycine in their little pod-shaped forms. Have some black beans with your chicken, some refried beans on your burrito, or make yourself a nice hearty pot of three-bean soup. Even baked beans can get a little glycine into your diet. You want to get a bare minimum of 3 grams of glycine daily. This is the smallest amount that you can have each day and still reach the amount of glycine that your body needs to function. If you want to supplement, a good starting dose for most of you will be 5 grams. This is the perfect amount for people who think that they might be glycine deficient. It's going to help get your body back on track fast. Start slow and work up to 10 grams or more, because taking too much at once may cause a bowel flush. That is one issue that no one wants to deal with. If you want more tips and tricks to feel better, then you should subscribe to our channel and like this video. And don't forget to leave a comment before you go. Which of those glycine-rich foods are you lacking in your diet?